Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. John Waite.
God bless you.
Every time I think of you, I always catch my breath, and I'm still standing here, and you're miles away, and I'm wondering why you left. And there's a storm that's raging through my frozen heart tonight. I ain't missing you.
It's 1979. I made my mom drive me to the record store because I wasn't going to risk dropping the album I was going to buy on my Schwinn. It was K-Tel's The Rock album. Isn't It Time?
Yeah.
Is on side B, and I scratched the heck out of Love and Touch and Squeezin' to get the needle to the babies.
As you should.
So, take that, Steve Perry. It's a pleasure.
Oh,
it's a
God
pleasure.
Bless you. Thanks. Nice to be here.
Thanks. We know these aren't musicians' hours, so we appreciate that. But, man, you're still touring.
Yeah, we had a new record out last year called Rough and Tumble. And we put that out, and we had number one single on the radio with the title track.
Yeah.
Which was like a hard rock track, which surprised everybody. So you just can't
tell. Did it surprise
tell.
You?
It just, yeah. It was kind of weird, because, I mean, at one point I thought, well, great, you know, number one single. And yet I was thinking, oh, no, I don't have to deal with the suits again. You know? So it was a double-edged sword, but it's increased the demand for us, so we play a lot more, which was the whole point, really, these days.
But it's the industry has changed so much from the time when I was getting on my bike to go buy vinyl.
Yeah.
To, I mean, the way the medium has changed, the way that
well,
people
you make
are
records,
getting it.
You make records to tour now. You don't really make records to sell huge amounts.
Units. They
units.
Yeah. That's a soup phrase.
Yeah, there you go. But if you do have a number one single, you get in the top 10. That you're nationwide, you know, and they start playing your old stuff, and then people want to see you again. I mean, we work twice as much now because of last year. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask you what Andy, my co-host, and I call the Rick Springfield question.
Yeah.
Do you get a little tired of singing Missing You? Does it ever get tired? Or
no,
is it the reaction,
no.
The vibe?
What's Rick Springfield got to do with that?
Jesse's Girl.
Okay.
Yeah, that,
yeah.
Sorry.
No, it's a beautiful song. No, it only took 10 minutes to write Missing You, and that maybe...
Really?
Yeah, and then maybe that's why it's so spontaneous. It isn't contrived in any way. And I think that's why it's enjoyable to sing. And it's like a blues song.
Yeah.
It's not like big operatic arena rock. It's more to the point, you know. I think it's an honesty in that song, and it touches people on a lot of different levels, if I dare say that. I mean, it's a beautiful thing to have a song that big.
You're gonna play in Kokomo tonight, Rushville tomorrow, but you're gonna play one more a little bit later, right?
Yeah, we are.
You're gonna stick around,
we're
relax.
We're gonna keep playing until you kick us off, you know. We're gonna keep playing.
You drink coffee?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
Move around. People.
No, I'm like this anyway.
I mean, people accuse me of being demonstrative, but this is
no,
so
no,
I'm
no,
just,
I, I'm just very energetic, you know.
Exactly. So hey, thanks.
Hey, God bless you.
Relax for a little bit, guys.
Yep,
stick
thank
around.
You. Thanks so much.
We'll be right back. When we come back, Andy's talking to Dr. Okay, immediately following Indystyle, CBS is going to have a continuing coverage of the shootings that took place in Colorado. They're going to have that coverage until noon when Wish TV 8 will,
that's right.
will take
so
back
that's
the news.
Up.
So that is coming up.
But before that.
We've been doing a lot of this today, but I haven't had mine yet. So
you want me to take your picture?
Yeah. You mind?
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Right? Are we on?
Yeah. Okay,
okay.
Hang on. Ready?
These are $5
two,
each, by the way.
Oh, that's fine. She's good.
Oh, that's a good one. Okay,
oh,
one more, too.
Oh, there you go.
Fabulous.
I didn't expect that on the air.
That's what we've been doing the whole hour. Introduce your mates.
Oh, yeah, all right. The man in black, all the way from Philadelphia, Tim Hogan.
Thanks, Tim.
Hey, Tim.
Yeah, and on the drums, we have Rondo. He's from New Jersey.
Yeah.
What's up?
And we have Kerri Kelli on guitar.
Awesome.
Hey, Kerri.
Yeah.
Whew.
Well, I tell you, sometimes you're up there and you go like, and on the bass guitar, and
well,
I go completely blank, you know.
Yeah.
I really do, you know, you hyperventilate.
Do you do that when you're like, hello,
Cleveland? No, I've done that before.
But it's Kokomo tonight.
Huh?
Right?
Yeah, no.
Just
Kokomo
approach.
Tonight and Rushville. The Pink
Kokomo, right, yeah.
The Pink Torpedoes are opening for you? I
There's
think
a band called the Pink Torpedoes?
Yeah, I think that's the name of them. Somebody hit me up on Facebook.
The Pink Torpedoes.
So,
all right.
Anyway,
I think I know those guys.
So get there early. Do you get different crowd vibes based on where you are when you're on tour, Midwest versus, say, East Coast or...
Well...
Crowd's a rock crowd.
Well, no, the Midwest crowds are usually pretty... They span all sort of age groups, and it's kind of like they have all the records, and they seem to be kind of like diehard fans. And either end of the country is kind of more like what's happening at the time.
Mm, okay.
But you get people, it's like Europe, you know, in Europe, everybody's like a real music fan, and they sort of know all the words, and they know the albums and stuff. It's a different vibe. For some reason, it's different everywhere.
I like your hair.
What an answer.
It's so shiny.
Is it really?
It looks fabulous.
I just washed it. I got out of bed this morning, quarter to six. Yeah.
I know, we appreciate it.
Oh, no, it's nice to be here.
You have no idea how much I appreciate it. I've had way too many conversations in this building about my hair, so
really?
I appreciate your hair.
Yeah, so we like it.
What are you going to be playing for us now?
We're going to do When I See You Smile.
Oh.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, all right. Set the DVRs, people.
Thank you. baby.